Okay, so wireless charging and COP warming, everything all in one. It's looks like an interesting device. So what's in the box? Well, we are going to see that right now. So this is how it arrived after ordering on Amazon. Everything seems to be written in Chinese. There's no English on it except this instruction over here. Hopefully it has some instruction inside, otherwise I don't think it's a very difficult item to use. I order it because I like the combo with the warming cup and the wireless charging in same time. So it looks interesting device. Let's see what's in the box right now. And for that we need to cut this seal tape, which is a good sign because that means that the item is new. It is sealed with the tape there. So it's good, cutting tape, here we go. So let's see what's it's in the box, what you get. All right. So first thing we see, it's the item itself, protected in the plastic bag here. So let's remove the bag and see how this device looks like. Try to don't destroy everything. It will be difficult, it's completely sealed bag again, another clue that you receive a new item. So unfortunately I will have to damage this bag. Here we go. I like to keep the bag usually to if I need to transport something or protect something, bags are always useful for this purpose. Okay, very shiny, very nice. Of course, don't put your finger there or hand here when it's hot. And the wireless charging pad right there, nice and shiny, very shiny. Very basic function, I guess charging, on, and heating. There we go with a free position micro USB for powering up. So not USB-C, micro USB here. And that's it, pretty basic. It's a 5 volts, 2 ampere. Yep. Well, here is the specification here. Let's see now what else they give you. Probably the charging cable. Yeah, here we go. Oh, I like that. It's very, very good quality cable, micro USB cable, but look, it's a threaded cable. So it's not plasticky, it's not crappy. It's very good quality cable they give you. Probably also it's a cable that it's rated for heat, because it looks like that. So yep, very well made cable right there to power your device. And that should be all for what's in the box. So that's how your device looks like. And with the cable, everything there, ready to use. Quite big, look at my hand next to it. So it's you have a nice big surface for heating your cup or even something bigger, and a nice surface to put your phone on for wireless charging. So now I'm impatient to go and try this. Looks very awesome. So for testing, I'm going to use one of my good quality cable. I know that this device comes with a good quality one, but I have one laying around, so I'm going to use mine just for the purpose of testing for this video. So let's connect this device with the micro USB cable. Being sure that it's not set to heat when connecting it, never know. All right, here we go. Now the light is red here. There is no light here that I can see. And red light here. All right, so it's set on charging. So let's try with my phone here. Put it on charging here. Nothing happened. Excellent. Ah. It took some time, but yes, it's going. It find the charging pad. The phone is off, so to be fair, it takes some time when your phone is off to charge. Here we go, it's charging, no problem. So that's good. Charging wireless charging pad works perfectly. I remove the phone now. So the phone is going to stay at 54%. The light is red here. All right. Now that's something to note with this device. It's unfortunately, like I told before when I was unboxing it, you cannot charge the phone and in the same time heat your cup. You have to decide which one you want to do. So it's either off in the middle, or charging, or heating. You cannot do both, unfortunately, with this device. So now let's test the heat. Since the charging pad works perfectly, I'm going to, this is off normally, in the middle, off, there we go, the light is off. Now I'm going to put to the heat switch. It's heat, so there is still no light that I can see to tell you that this pad is heating up. The light from the wireless disappear. So let's see now, put it here. It should be heating, no touching like the icon said, but I do have a thermometer here to measure how hot it gets. So let's see. It's been a while now that I've been putting my favorite mug on this heating pad, and I still don't see any heat there. So I'm gonna point the thermometer to the hot surface, supposedly hot. It's still on 67, 68, which is not hot at all, 68, 67. So yeah, it is not heating at all. Let's remove the cup, take a quick measurement under. No, it's nothing moved more than 68 degrees Fahrenheit, which is in Celsius, around 20 degrees. And yeah, it's not hot at all. And if I check, the position is still on heat here, because in the middle it's off, I believe, and then here it's charging. When I put it charging, the light for charging turned on, but I'm gonna put that hot position. We have nothing like 19 degrees Celsius, 67 Fahrenheit. So, to be fair, I did some more testing after reading on the box that they say that this device has to be plugged to a computer USB port and to not use any of the other device, which is a bit weird. Previously, when I was testing it, I was using a basic USB plug. It's not a fast charger. They say to avoid using fast charger. This is like just a basic USB, a 5-volt USB plug. It was not working with that. I also tested it with a portable battery pack. Also, it was not working. Battery pack was full, so it was not working. But now that I plug this device on my laptop here, so it's plugged on my laptop, plug all the way to here, now it starts to work. So let's see. I do have, when I turn on the switch to heat, I do have now a green light here that is kind of flashing, as you can see. So maybe it indicates that the pad is heating. So let's see now with the thermometer what we have. Again, connecting this pad to a normal laptop and not using any other source. I still have 19 degrees Celsius, or so still around 68 Fahrenheit. The light is blinking. I wonder what that means. Maybe it wait for me to put something on it. So after leaving this device on blinking light for like 10 minutes, now we have a different temperature on it. We do have in 21 degrees Celsius, and it went up all the way to 71.8.72 degrees Fahrenheit, 73. It keep coming up a little bit, 74. So yes, it's definitely warming up now. So the warming up function works perfectly if, of course, you connect it to a laptop or a normal computer. If I touch quickly the pad, I can feel some heat. If I leave my hand, I can really feel the heat, but touching it quickly, it's fine. But yes, it is quite hot now, so works as expected, so that's good. So yes, after a while, the bottom of the cup is slightly warm. And now we get, let's see, we have, it's difficult to get current reading, 71 here, 73, here we go, 74, 75, so it's much better than what I was getting before. The pad is now on since like 20 minutes, so it needs some time to warm up. You cannot just like turn it on and put immediately your mug on expecting to be hot. You need some time to warm up. So turn on the pad like, I don't know, 30 minutes before you make your coffee, for example. 76, I think, which should be around 20. It's not like as hot as I expected to see, but although my thermometer may be a little bit less accurate at that close range, because when I touch the pad, definitely I can feel the heat. If I leave my hand a little bit longer than that, I can like feel that I'm going to burn myself. So it is hot, and you can feel the heat coming on the bottom of the mug. So definitely works on that side. So again, don't use a normal connector, USB plug. Don't use a block, power block, or don't use a fast charger. Only plug this device to your laptop or desktop, and it should work just fine. Here we go again, testing positive. Thanks again for watching, and hope you enjoyed this video.